Welcome back to CSN. This episode will be full of teachers in honor of Teacher Appreciation Week. Hope you enjoy the video.
As you might know, Teacher Appreciation Week is coming up right around the corner. Today I'm here with Madison, and she's going to tell me what she appreciates most about her teacher.
I appreciate when they make class fun.
Good answer.
I'm here with Zach. Zach, what do you appreciate most about your teachers?
Their dedication to the students to make sure they pass.
I'm back again asking students about their teacher. Here with Matthew, tell us, what do you appreciate most about your teacher?
When I get acknowledged.
I agree.
Hi, I'm here with Levi, and with him wanting to be a teacher, we're going to see what he appreciates most about teachers.
I appreciate the time that they invest and the effort that they put in to make sure that the kids understand their work and they get their homework in on time.
Great answer.
I don't know what to say.
Hi, I'm here with Grant. Grant, what do you appreciate most about your teachers?
Hike's pretty cool.
All right.
Hey folks, I'm here with Mrs. Snygowski. She's going to tell me what she appreciated most from her teacher.
I liked it when they made class fun, and I also liked it when they weren't intimidating, so I could get up there and ask for help if I needed it.
Nice. Friendly. All right, Avery, time for us to answer the question. I appreciate how approachable my teachers are and how I can always get extra help or extra work if needed.
I'd say probably their unending devotion for students.
Nice.
Musical.ly's with teachers.
Rips on your ways from way back way. You know that I don't play. Streets not safe, but I never run away. Even when I'm away. OT. There's never much love when we go OT. I pray to make it back in one piece. I pray. That's why I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me. I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. More time, but I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me.
Strength and guidance. Let's see the finished project.
Jesse is a friend. Yeah, I know he's been a good friend of mine. Girl, and I wanna make her mine. And she's watching him with those eyes. And she's loving with that body, I just know it. And he's holding her in his arms late at night.
His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already, mom's spaghetti. He's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud.
Musical.ly's with teachers.
Teacher Appreciation Week is here, and the dad teachers need some love too.
So we need to go out and find some dad jokes.
Let's do it.
Hey Avery, how you doing?
I'm all right.
Really? I thought you were half left.
What was the name of the heaviest knight in King Arthur's court?
I have no idea.
Circumference. He ate too much pie. Did you know 5 out of every 4 people are horrible with fractions?
Why did the Clydesdale give a pony a glass of water? Because he was a little horse. If you see a robbery at an Apple store, does that make you an eyewitness? Oh, that the first French fries weren't actually cooked in France? They were cooked in Greece. Why didn't the vampire attack Taylor Swift? She had bad blood.
Nice.
Did you know the first French fries weren't actually made in France? Or they weren't actually cooked in France?
Hey guys, all right, so with this segment today, we're gonna have teachers taking other teachers' tests. So what we're going to do is we're going to have Mr. Caney. He claims to be a Spanish guru. He's going to take one of Mrs. Ross's tests. Mrs. Ross, who's a Spanish teacher here at the school, claims to know everything about Spanish, and we don't know how much English she really does know, so we're going to have her take one of Mrs. Newbright's English tests, and then Mrs. Newbright is going to take one of Mr. Caney's science tests. And at the end of all this, we're going to tally up the results to find out which teacher here is really the smartest.
Y'all ready for this?
Hey guys, today we're here with Mrs. Muller, and I'm just going to ask her, so what was your favorite subject in school?
My favorite subject in school was art class. I took a college prep program, but my art class was where I relaxed, the one place where I could just kind of be myself and just kind of meditate for the day to work off the stress. But if it wasn't art, my next favorite was history. Everything about history, loved it. Could read the history textbook front to back.
That's awesome, thanks. Hey guys, today we're here with Mrs. Shum. I'm just gonna ask her what her favorite class was whenever she was in school.
In college, my favorite class was English. I had a professor, Dr. Rookie, who loved his job, made it so much fun. And I thought if I would enjoy teaching that much, it would be the best profession to have.
That's awesome, thanks.
Hi, I'm here with Mrs. Schmidtmeyer, and I'm gonna ask her what her favorite class in school was. So,
I'm going to say my calculus class, believe it or not, because started out my teacher was pretty cute, and then I figured out I liked math. So, yeah.
Great, thank you. Hi, I'm here with Mrs. Tribio, and I'm going to ask her what her favorite class was in school.
My favorite class was actually English, if you can believe it or not.
Awesome, thanks.
We students would like to give a special shout out and thank you to Mrs. Burden and Mrs. Ritter for the hard work they put in to organize prom. I hope you guys enjoy these pictures from our special otherworldly prom night.
Oh, don't you dare look back, just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back, she said shut up and dance with me. This woman is my destiny, she said.
And that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed that teacher-filled episode. Join us next time for our farewell to the 2017-2018 school year.